Hi, I'm Samantha Saren, a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi and Associates, and we're going to talk a little bit about behavior analysis in the community, specifically about its application to job safety, which is also known as behavior-based safety. Behavior-based safety falls under organizational behavior management, which most of us are familiar with when it comes to monitoring and changing overall employee performance. But behavior-based science more precisely focuses on workplace practices that relate to safety. Behavior-based safety interventions start in much the same way as you'd expect when you're working with a learner with autism. I'm going to talk about three studies that look at behavior-based safety and discuss how the implications of each study translate into clinical settings that we're more used to. A 1987 study on the long-term effects of a token economy on safety performance in open pit mining looked at employees earning stamps for time that they worked without injury, for following adapted safety procedures, and for doing some kind of preventative safety measure. They also then could lose stamps for essentially the opposite conditions, either getting injured or damaging equipment or failing to report anything safety related. The employees with these stamps, they could then trade them in for various items. So what the study found following implementation of the token system was reductions in the number of injuries at work, the number of time lost due to those injuries, and reductions in the costs of accidents and injuries. This study used a token economy with a response cost. Behavior analysts very commonly use token economies in applied settings. A token, or condition reinforcer, is delivered contingently on the display of a desired behavior. How often or how many tokens can be earned depends on the type of schedule in place for each particular economy. Once enough tokens have been earned, the tokens can be exchanged for a number of reinforcers. An example similar to that of the study is actually our very own Diddy Dollars system that we use at Brett DiNovi & Associates. We're able to earn tokens, which we call Diddy Dollars, for specific behaviors such as completing weekly surveys on time, working additional in-home sessions, being recognized as especially helpful by a colleague, and so on. Diddy Dollars can be exchanged at our company marketplace for a host of reinforcers, such as vacations, laptops, clothing, or additional paid time off. Another study from 2009, Preventing Back Injuries in Hospital Settings, the effects of video modeling on safe patient lifting by nurses. In this study, a handful of nursing staff members were provided information on how to correctly perform a one-person transfer. So the nursing staff received training on video scoring and information on the procedure itself, the one-person transfer. What this study found was that integrity in performing the one-person transfer, improvements were observed pretty immediately after they had done the training and the video modeling for the nursing staff. So video modeling can be used not only with the person that is going to be performing the intervention, but also as a way for training. If you have multiple staff on a team and are having trouble coordinating training all of them, maybe someone works during the day, someone else works at night, video modeling is a great way to catch up with everyone and ensure that the content is delivered consistently and efficiently. So you could record yourself demonstrating a particular intervention or procedure and then send that recording to each of your staff to then review. Lastly, in a 2010 study, the effects of response effort on safe performance by therapists at an autism treatment facility. This study examined levels of difficulty in performing tasks like wearing gloves, using hand sanitizer, and in replacing electrical outlets. So when the level of difficulty to complete these tasks was modified, the levels were scored with values of high, medium, or low. When the level was modified to low effort, all employees increased their performance adherence to those tasks. Manipulating response effort, or making a task easier or harder to complete, is such a clever technique in that you can intervene in a way that produces behavior change without directly targeting the behavior itself. This could be comparable to setting up a data sheet for staff with simple and organized methods of data collection. If you are a staff and you look at a data sheet that has 12 behaviors on it, all with different methods of collection. You've got frequency, you've got interval, you've got a momentary time sample on there. We're talking about a lot of response effort on the part of the staff to collect that data correctly. If you simplify that data sheet, making the bit easier to collect, you're going to get better data collection integrity. If you like this video and are interested in more clinical content, please subscribe to our channel by clicking the link below.